Praise the Lord. What an honor it is to come back with another word from God. I praise God so much. And I also pray and hope that many of your questions would be answered through this short message. So in our lives, we have many questions. It might not be a common question, but something that is related with our spiritual lives, especially when a believer who truly lives closer to God, but all of a sudden, in an unimaginable way, loses everything. Things that shouldn't happen have happened. The marriage is broken, health is hopeless, or losing someone that is really close to him. Or when the people that you have trusted the most have rebelled against you or broke your trust. What you have dreaded the most has come upon you. And the only question that comes to our mind at that point is, why God, why? Why have you allowed this trouble? Wasn't I being good? Wasn't I living close to you? Wasn't I living at peace with everyone? The people who are far from you are doing much better than I am. Why did this have to happen only with me? I cannot assure you that I have all the answers, but I can say that this could be the reasons why God must have allowed it. If we see, God always works from the bottom up. He always raises people from the bottom. He doesn't hand us a ready-made throne. If we see Joseph, first he has a dream. He has a vision about how he will shine like a sun, that how all of his brothers will bow down to him. But it turned out to be exactly opposite. He was thrown into a pit. He was accused as a criminal. He was made guilty for what he did not do. He was kept at the lowest state. What was the dream? But what was actually happening in reality? What was God's vision for? But what is this pit? God, you said you'll make me great, but why am I treated like this? Don't you think all these questions could have occurred to him? In the same way, David. God said he'll make him a king. But since he was anointed, it took almost 15 years for him to become a king. Those 15 years were the toughest. He had to hide in caves, walk in deserts, protect himself from his enemies. He had to pretend he was a fool so he could save his life. He overcame many tribulations, rebellions, and passed many tests. At the end of all this, he becomes a king. And we all know about Job. God allowed the enemy to disturb and destroy everything he had. He came to the worst of what any person could imagine. Don't you forget our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ, when he was on the cross, cried out, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me? Christ knew God's plan all along, but unable to bear the grief and abandonment, he cries out, "Why did you leave me?" All of us, like him, face those kind of situations in our lives. In this context, I would like to share three things with you. Firstly, why God allows us these tribulations is for his glory and for our benefit. You might have a question, isn't this injustice? How could this possibly be good? How can he take away everything, my joy, my closest people not giving me what I want and say it's all for my good? Doesn't this question come to you? You know, what you think is good for you might end up as a curse for your life. Likewise, what you think is useless, what you think is unworthy might turn out to be a real blessing in your life. God turns out everything good at the right time. Only time will tell us why God allowed some things in our lives. But if we are stubborn-hearted and are stern on getting our own way, what a disaster it will turn out to be. Trust God's plan. He is a God who delights in doing good for us. Sometimes he takes us through these tests to bring glory to his name. He might allow these tough times so that people around you might see how God works in your life and believe and glorify him. They might say, how this person is troubled in his life. Is there any way he can come out of this? Can he be delivered from this at all? Doesn't he believe in God? Let us see if this God whom he believes in so much will deliver him. They might be looking forward to see if God will ever bring you out of this. And when you pass these tests and with this see God's amazing deliverance, they start to trust in God too. they start to build their faith in God too. Also, many a times He changes our pattern, our routines. He scrapes off and takes off some things in our lives for our benefit. Everybody goes through pain in this world, but it depends on us, on how we react to it. Secondly, why God allows tribulations is to strengthen our faith. We all by experience can say that when all is well, when everything's going just the way we planned, there's not really much of faith, is there? Is there a need to depend on God at all? So we come to the bottom of our life of faith. But when we were first saved, the amount of joy, the amount of excitement and enthusiasm is unspeakable. But as time and years pass by, we are so used to God's word, His works and miracles that it doesn't amaze us anymore. That's why in James 1:2-3 it says, "My brothers and sisters, consider it nothing but joy when you fall into all sorts of trials, because you know that the testing of your faith produces endurance." Tests will make us patient. They strengthen our faith. They give us a hope. Only then do we lift our eyes up and call upon Him, right? Faith is not birthed easy. Faith gets tested in fire. And only in sufferings, the faith reaches greater heights. And not to forget, it brings us real close to God. Maybe that is why we face these tribulations. God wants to remind you of a verse today. "When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze." Maybe the waters are coming upon you. You might be walking in fire, but they won't burn you. That is our God. He is with us in all of this. Thirdly, why we are allowed tribulations is because we're not ready yet. It is all about preparation. If we aren't ready, God cannot do much for us. He will not hand us down anything. He will not begin anything new in our lives. For God to bring us up, we need to prepare. As I've mentioned earlier, David was made king 15 years after being anointed. Why not? Why couldn't God make him king then? God's ways are different than ours. That's why in Isaiah 55:8-9, the verses say, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts." The lessons that David learned those 15 years to depend solely on God, to be humble, to submit, to realize that only God is his refuge, he wouldn't have learned otherwise. He wouldn't have understood if he became king as soon as he was anointed. God always wants us to wait, not for him, but for us. Also, the Israelites had to travel 40 years instead of 11 days because it wasn't about the travel, it's about building their character. Preparation is not just from the outside, it's from the inside out. Change on the inside, integrity and character building on the inside. God carves out the rebellious nature in us little by little. If we're still full of pride and immature and expecting God to give us great things is unwise. But when we're mature enough, grateful, have a broken and contrite spirit, then God starts to unveil His great plans and starts the process of blessing us. If God starts His great manifestation right now, are you ready to receive it yet? Just as a knife is sharpened by fire, just as it is used after being sharpened, just as it is used to cut tough things, so it is with us. Tests are used to sharpen us. It makes us stern. It makes us firm, to make us a new creation. It prepares us for the abundant life that God wants to give us. Make a note, if you just try to imagine God's plan for our lives, it's beyond our understanding. That's why in Romans 8:18 it says, "I consider that our present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed in us." So if God says that our suffering is nothing comparatively to His glory that He wants to give us, just imagine. believe. Fight the good fight, and may God give you the strength to endure all kinds of tribulations. God bless you all.